Natalia Lebedeva, the Soviet champion, was certainly one of the strongest contenders in the women's competition. She's seen here skating to a second place finish, the first figure, a back double three, change double three. Secure in her abilities to skate figures, she seems to be cool and composed. This emotional calm has never been seen, however, in her free skating routines. Jill Trenery, the U.S. champion, got off to a commanding lead by winning both the school figures. Here we see her skate a forward loop change loop. If the general public could see the figures the way this incredible camera work is done, I feel that figures would not have the mystique that they have historically and would have become more interesting to the public at large. Midori Ito, defending Japanese world champion, was perceived as being completely invincible prior to the competition. But here, losing her balance and actually skidding on the top of the loop, she plummeted to 16th position after the second figure and ended up 10th overall, a first for any world champion. Lisa Sargent, the Canadian champion, scored a major success by skating good strong figures and finishing 7th overall. This is a phenomenal accomplishment for a beginner in Worlds, as it usually takes several years to crack the top 10, at least for the Canadian competitors. And once again, a moment of history. Here we see a Yugoslavian skating the very last figure in the World Championship. If there's any irony in this accomplishment, the figure she skated was a good one. A bit of sarcasm there by the Finnish judge of 6. And as the last figure is eradicated by the Zamboni, it goes to an icy death, just as the roses will.
Silver Sargent, just turned 19. She moved up from being 3rd in Canada last year and skated very solid figures here, 7th going into this, her original program.
Compare this program to the program of Yamaguchi. here for Lisa Sargent is not just skating a flawless program, but it is coming into World Championships as an unknown, landing right into the top 10 and skating like a veteran. Standing ovation for her.
Canada's champion, Lisa Sargent, and her mark are coming up next. As she had done in her figures, Lisa Sargent got very good marks in this original program. The highest we've seen by any skater so far. She is the leader right now as far as the original program is concerned. And here's Midori Ito, and what an uphill climb she has. She was 10th after figures. Last year in Paris, 6th at this stage of the game.
I don't know if you recognize that look in her face, but that look we've seen before. We saw it in the eyes of Boitano at the Olympics. We saw it in the eyes of Forrester at World Championships in Budapest. What it means is I'm going to go out for the kill. This kind of jumping has not been seen really ever in women's competition, and she simply is in a class by herself when it comes to those jumps.
Midori Ito. Midori Ito's marks were what we expected they would be. She had 6.5.9 for her technical marks. All the rest for 5.8, save 2. And now it's Jill Trenary, 3 times U.S. champion. She has the world championship really within her grasp here, as she did win the figures. And her toughest rivals were all having problems there.
Well, Ted, Tracy and I were just commenting about the appearance. The appearance is so dazzling. The dress so dazzling, the body so dazzling, that she, for me, she's already got a 7.0.
She looks like a world champion.
Thank you.
lost the world championship right on that very combination. Midori Ito is creeping closer by the minute. Except for the appearance.
Well, what mark will she receive? We'll see when we return after this. One mark of 5'8", and technically she had a 5'3", and a lot of 5'4"s. In this original program, she is thus third so far. Ito beat her in the original, as did Christy Yamaguchi, her teammate. She is, however, still first overall because she won figures. Is already superior to that of Jill Trenary. It was a great performance for me. Well, her marks are going to be extremely interesting, and they're going to be a key, really, to what happens.
As Carter represents the United States, Colin Cook.
Well, Natalia Lebedeva certainly did Jill Trenary no favors at all. She beat her in this original program. She had 7 higher marks than did Jill Trenary, and that, of course, knocked Trenary down. Medvedeva went ahead of her, but more importantly, that put Trenary down into 4th place in the original. Here is Holly Cook, her young American teammate, who had good figures here. She was 4th, this young lady from Bountiful, Utah.
Now, what we're seeing with this performance in comparison to her teammate Trenary is an incredible, aggressive attack on the program.
So she can really put the cat amongst the pigeons here. We'll see. Certainly impressed the judges. She had the 3rd highest score in that original program, and that moved her up 2 places from 4th into 2nd, and also helped more to bury her teammate, Jill Trenary. Canada's Lisa Sargent was 6th in that original program, 7th overall, and right now she is with Brian Williams. Brian?
A very happy Lisa Sargent and her coach Michael Juranek, your first world championship, and you have a clean program. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. I felt really good out there tonight and very confident, very sure of myself.
Now tell me about this big crowd, more than 9,000. I know it's great to skate at home, but does it put pressure on you?
Not really. I like to think of it as being very positive, and I like to perform. I like to, you know, get into the crowd and let them enjoy my performance.
Michael, this has to be a dream come true. Kurt last night and another championship performance here tonight.
Oh, it's great. I'm enjoying this really tremendously, and I just can't complain.
She handles pressure so well.
We've been trying to work on it, and it looks like she's on the right track.
All right, I know you have to go for some interviews. What do you do tonight now? Do you just get a good night's sleep? Do you have meetings? Do you forget about it? How do you prepare for tomorrow?
Nothing. We won't do nothing tonight, not even talk about it, and tomorrow we'll do the strategy.
All right, have a restful night. I know you have to get to a news.